Hello, darlings! Today on Vinky's Gaming Thoughts, hidden tarot cards that potentially depict the story of Flemeth. These Easter eggs can be found in Skyhold by Flycam. They were originally found by Fernrain and then brought to light by Gil Dirthalan, Calwern Dirtharan, and Vir Tanadal. They speculate that these four tarot cards depict the story of Flemeth, which makes sense, especially considering all the lore regarding Flemeth and Mythal in Dragon Age Inquisition. There's a lot to unpack here with what is within these four tarot cards. We have lovers, a dragon, a death referred to as the stab, and the gathering or funeral. I believe the order would be lovers, stab, gathering, dragon. The lovers depict most likely Flemeth and Osen. They are embracing, a warm embrace, security, protection. Below them in the pattern are tiny bells, wedding bells. Bells also represent the female force and the celestial vault. Flemeth did have many daughters. Bells represent magic as well. The moon is large and full, also representative of magic. And Flemeth is a mage. The full moon is also associated with magical rituals, which Flemeth is known for. Marriage, or the binding of love, can be seen as magical also. In Kabbalah, the moon represents the seed of life, which contrasts with the stab from the next card. The lovers are also clad in black and gold. Dark robes here could represent the hidden, the secrets, mysteries, the occult. Gold as a color represents illumination, love, compassion, courage, passion, magic, and wisdom. I find that very descriptive of Flemeth. She embodies many emotions and she is all these qualities. There are triangles in the pattern which symbolize various trinities, such as mind, body, spirit, mother, father, child, past, present, future, mother, maiden, crone, which Flemeth has been and now is the crone, creation, preservation, and destruction. This last trinity is interesting to me. Flemeth may have only created children and seen the destruction of her husband, but with Mythal within her, the creation of Elvenon, the preservation of the people, and the destruction of Elvenon, and perhaps the destruction of Thedas. Even if here Flemeth has not yet met Mythal in the story of this particular tarot card, past, present, and future are depicted as a trinity and hinted at. The stab. We see Flemeth by Osen's side. He is stabbed. I believe he is lying down, and that behind him is water. Behind his head are splashes, ripples in the water. Water represents the unconscious. In the fade, there are the emerald waters. In death, you return to the fade. In tarot, water represents the energy flow of living things. Now, the stab is rather unique. It's a circle, cycle of life and death. The red of the blood of life looks like flames, perhaps rage and war in this case. And it has a green ring around it, green for the heart chakra, healing. The sword is a symbol of power and destruction. In tarot, the suit of swords can represent understanding, like it can represent domination and command. Osen's life has ended, pierced through the heart, the center of the target, a bullseye. His eyes close, but it opens Flemeth's eyes to the truth. See what I did just there? If there is a bit of wind also behind Osen's head, air goes with the suit of swords as well. The winds have changed, giving prediction to the major change in transformation Flemeth is soon to live. On their robes are lozenges, which represent the inner focus that a person needs to hold on to their life task during their lifetime. Osen's life has ended, but Flemeth's life task will now change. The funeral. There's a gathering that looks like a funeral. We have a hill where the dead were typically buried in medieval times. A skull represents death, a graveyard. It's a scene similar to the scene in Hamlet with Hamlet and the gravedigger. Below a tree are people gathered, looking sad, and atop the small hill stands who I believe is Flemeth, with her crown-like, helmet-like headpiece. She has her right hand up, which in magic represents benevolence. In Thedas, the right hand of the divine takes action and stands at the front of the battle. So Flemeth fights for benevolent cause. The crosses on her robes represent tombstones of the graveyard, and next to her head, it almost looks like the shape of a hala, but cast in shadow. So perhaps an elven link, the ill fate that befell Mythal, or perhaps Mythal hidden, observing. And then we have the dragon, the transformation. Flemeth's transformation, as Mythal's spirit is within her. The dragon is in a red and orange sky. Anger, revenge, passion, new life. Circle equals new life cycles. It expresses the dragon's shriek. Again, triangles, bringing us back to the various trinities that are present and embodied here. Birds represent omens of the future. They represent a soul's journey for higher knowledge and symbolize the wide range of emotions one may feel all at once. That can be a little disconcerting at times. When Flemeth speaks, there are many emotions sometimes in what she says. It's one sentence, but in her tone of voice, we can hear, we can feel many emotions. Birds also represent the link between heaven and earth. So Thedas, the earth, and the Fade, the heavens. Flemeth, being of the earth, now linked with Mythal, a being of the Fade. The dragon has two tongues, duality, but also two beings live within, together now, Flemeth and Mythal. The dragon has three eyes, not quite like the eye of the maker, but representing again the Trinity and seeing all. The eyes are green as if from the Fade, and the dragon itself symbolizes strength, wisdom, power, and hidden knowledge. And boy, does Flemeth know a lot of hidden knowledge. Hidden truths, because Mythal knows a lot of things that have been hidden from the beings of Thedas, hidden from us, the players. So again, thanks to Fernrain and Gil Dilthalan, Calward, Dirtharan, and Veer Tanadal for tweeting these tarot cards, bringing them to light. And let me know what you think in the comments below regarding these four tarot cards and the potential that it represents the story of Flemeth. Maybe I missed some details and you're noticing something I didn't, so let me know in the comments below. As per usual, like this video if you like it, subscribe to be Rosie approved, especially if you love Dragon Age. Check out my merchandise for some exclusive and Rosie approved merchandise. And I'll see you all soon. Masaranas. If you're new here and you like my content, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon for notifications. Like it if you like it, for the like it if you like it dance. You can also follow my website, binkyproductions.com, where I post everything from all my channels. Exclusive! If you want to support me, consider buying my book, Stardust Destiny's One, Variant Facing, Magic, Dragons, Fantasy. All relevant links below. Thank you so much for your time. Your continued viewership is very much appreciated. Masaranas.